Hi, this is Cindy from Vintage to New with another video tutorial. This little pattern is my baby book pattern. Inside you'll find all of these really cute little faces that are completely baby safe. It looks like this. There's lots of little things for the kids to play with and chew on. These little tags here on the side. I want to point out that for this particular pattern, I use the cam snaps for the eyes. They're a safety child snap. I'll put a link to that in my description below for where to find these. If you don't have these and don't want to purchase the cam snap tool, you can get a starter kit for about $25. You could use safety eyes that they use for bears. You know, like if you're making a homemade soft doll, they have safety eyes. You could also use embroidery, hand embroidery, the face. I don't recommend using buttons for the eyes. They don't recommend using buttons anymore because the child chews on it and they can come loose. I show in the video how to do the machine embroidery with just simple stitches for the facial features, or you could use hand embroidery for those. But there's lots of little textures and fun things for the kids to keep their interest going. So anyway, let's get started on how to make this. The first step that I did is I took each of the pictures of the little animals for the book, and it just takes little scraps of fabric, and I determined what scraps that I wanted for each little animal. My one tip is for your pages to use really high contrast fabric. In this section I have what's going to be a light and dark together and a dark, and you'll see I'll strategically place the animals on there. So an animal that has, like the sheep or the panda, which is mostly white, I'll put it on the black background, and the others should do fine on the stripe. For all of the heads of each of the animals, I do an applique method where I use the interfacing on the inside. This is fusible interfacing. It does not need to be fusible interfacing. I recommend not using fusible, but this is what I had on hand, and it's what I use in the video. So just some lightweight interfacing is what you need. The one other piece that we're going to use is Pellon fusible fleece. You could use regular fleece if you wanted to quilt it, or whatever your skill set is. If you're a quilt maker, you'll have great ideas. If you're not a quilt maker, this is a really great way to start. So fusible fleece, and I'll show you how to use that as we go along also. One thing I wanted to point out in my fabric selections for these little animals, little babies love texture, lots and lots of texture. So for the little lamb, you could use the fleece fabric if you had some, but I chose to use a white terry cloth. This is just a little washcloth. And then for the little kitty cat, I bought a at the dollar store an orange terry cloth kitchen towel, and that's what I'm going to use for the face of the kitty cat. So keep in mind textures and introduce those whenever you can. So here are the pages of my book laid out. I have what I'm going to use for the cover, and I just picked something that was really brightly colored and a really interesting little design that I don't have to do anything with to make it a really cute cover. So this will be the cover of our book. I'm going to use this one as the inside page of the book. Now, that will go right with the cover this way. And then these two pieces here, and I have cut the fusible fleece to match each one of those, is going to go this way and this way. So that's what the book is going to look like, and you will end up sewing it down the middle, so your page will look like, when you open it, like this, and then the front cover like that. And that'll become more clear as we work our way through this tutorial. But for right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this over, and I'm going to iron the fusible fleece to the wrong side of my pages, and you can feel it's a little bit of glue dots on the back here, and just follow the manufacturer's instructions. I'll show you what it looks like when I get back. Okay, so now you can see that I have fused the fusible fleece to the inside of the front and back and each of the pages. The other thing I've done, let me zoom in so you can see here, is I have drawn a line down the center of each one of the pages so that I can find the center, and I'll show you why in a minute. I'm going to do the little lamb first. So I've taken my pattern and I have traced around the head, around the face, and the ear. Now, a couple of words. On all of these pages, we want to make sure everything is completely baby safe. I want to make the ears so that they are loose, so they're fun to play with, but you'll notice on the pattern, there's this little dotted part here. That's what I want to slide under the face, and then we're going to sew over the top, very securely attaching the ears. So that's one. The other thing is, the lamb is the only one that's asymmetrical, meaning the face isn't the same on both sides. So when I traced it out, I put an R on it for the right side, and I'll show you why in just a minute. So here I have my washcloth, okay? This is the pellon, what will be the right side of this, which this particular fabric doesn't have a right side or a wrong side, but if you chose a fabric that does have, put it towards the right side. I left the tracing line here, and now I pinned it down. The thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sew through all these layers, and I'm going to go over to my machine. I'm going to sew right on that line, and then I'll come back and show you what to do next. Okay, as you can see, I sewed right on that line all the way around with my pellon and my little washcloth. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out, leaving about a quarter inch seam all the way around, and then I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so it's all cut out. Now the first thing I'm going to do is rip off the paper that I had traced. Okay, it should rip off pretty easy along your stitches, like so. Okay, it's all been torn off. Now here's the side of the pellon. And if I open it like this, you can see that it makes a little sandwich. On the pellon, just in the very center back, I'm gonna just cut it open. Okay, so I cut a slit in the back. And now all I'm gonna do is turn it right side out. So basically, I'm just making a little applique using the pellon as the inside piece. All right, it's gonna look something like that. There's the slit in the back. Here's the front. Okay, to do the lamb's face, here is the traced piece, just like so. All right, and I marked it with an R, so I know that's the right side. I'm going to use iron on like Wonder Under. It's a fusible web. It's got glue and paper. On the paper side, I'm going to draw the face, but I'm going to put the R side down, okay? And then I'm going to trace around this and cut it out, and I'll show you. Okay, so here's the little lamb where I had traced his face. I picked it up. I put it down on the paper side of the Wonder Under and turned it over. Traced around it. I left a good quarter inch around each side. Now I'm going to go over and follow the manufacturer's instructions and iron this piece of Wonder Under to the wrong side of the face fabric. So here's what it looks like ironed on. So now I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to cut exactly on the line that I traced all the way around. So here's what it looks like after it's been cut out, and as you can see, it's exactly the same as the lamb. It's not a mirror image. Now I'm going to cut out the ears and show you what to do with those next. For the ears, I've just cut out the pattern that we traced and pinned it onto the fabric. And it's got the little extended piece here. And I'm gonna cut it just slightly larger than the pattern. We're gonna just zigzag around the edge of these. I found they're so small and hard to turn right side out. So anyway, just kind of like that, and you need four of them. So there's my first set. I'll do another set, and then I'll come right back. I'm here at the sewing machine, and I have the ear. So this is the part that goes next to the face, and this is the little pointy part here. I've got both pieces. I'm going to put it under my presser foot, and I've set my machine to do a fairly tight zigzag. And so I'm just gonna start going casting half on and half off the little ears, and just zigzag them together. So, like so. Now, these little ears, they're gonna pull on them and chew on them. They're gonna take lots of wear and tear. So I'm probably gonna go around the edge of this little ear three times to be sure that it's very well caught and sturdy and can take some beating. So I'll do that and then come back. Okay, so now we're ready to start placement of the ears and the face on our little lamb. So to take off the paper on the back of your Wonder Under, if you score it with a pin like that, it makes life a lot easier. You can just pull it off like so. All right. Then what we're gonna do is the chin lines up perfectly like so. And then I'm going to take the little ear, I'm going to tuck it about a quarter of an inch under the head, like that. So it's nice and tucked under, and then I'm going to pin it so that it stays in the right spot. And then I'm going to do the same over here, making sure that I've got it tucked in about a quarter inch, and then I'm going to pin it. All right. Okay, I did a quick press of this little face piece, and it's adhered. Okay, I'm going to go around this edge with my applique stitch, which is just a very narrow zigzag. I'm making it very narrow and very short, and I'm going to go across the edge. And I'm probably going to go around this face part two or three times to make it a nice applique stitch to hold this down. So anyway, I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. Okay, as you can see, I've appliqued around two or three times, have a nice little zigzag satin stitch there. Now I am gonna go back and forth over these ears with just a straight stitch for just a double guarantee that they're gonna be nice and tight. I'll do that on both sides. Okay, this is the tracing of the head that I had that we ripped out, and I saved it. I traced on where the nose goes, and I used a little piece of fabric and did like we did with the face, with a little piece of Wonder Under underneath of it so that I can get the placement for where the nose goes. And now I'm just gonna use my applique stitch, just like we did here around the nose. And you can iron it on first if you want to. Okay, at this point, you're gonna need to decide how you want to do the eyes for your little animals. I'm gonna use my cam snap or babyville snap or drit snap applicator. They're little plastic snaps that have a big spike that comes up in the middle, and then you put this piece on the back and smash it down, and they're okay for baby clothes, so they should be okay for a baby book. They're very safe, can't come apart if you do it right and follow the instructions. If you don't have one of these, you can purchase safety eyes like you would use in a teddy bear or something like that. With those, you push them through, and there's a big washer that attaches to the back so that they can't come through. If you don't want to do any of these, you could embroidery the eyes on, which would be just adorable. And so you need to decide what you want to use. If you're going to embroidery, it would be easiest to do it at this stage right here, so you can see the placement and you don't have the back page on yet. Now, I am going to use these, but I'm not going to do it yet. I want to do it when I get it to the page, because I want to have extra fabric in there to make sure that it's just very secure. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to attach this to the page. All right, we're ready to attach our applique into our page of our book. I've made sure that it's going up and down straight like this. I've measured over 1 inch from the center of the book to his ear, and I've pinned it down into place. Now, eventually we're going to trim up the edge of this book, so we're just going on keeping everything an inch away from the center seam that we marked, the center line of our book here. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and applique stitch this down all the way around. I'm going to lift up his ear because I don't want to sew his ear down. I want to have that movement of the ear. So here we have our little lamb so far. He's been attached to our page. Now we're going to add the detail of his little smile. Now you can use a water-soluble marker or anything that will wash out to mark that, or you can just kind of eyeball it. We're going to use our machine to thread paint, just kind of freehand sew that on, and I'll show you what I mean. Or if you're not comfortable with that, you could hand embroidery the little face on if that's what you would like. So let me show you how I'm going to do it, and then you can decide what you would like to do. All right, I'm going to do mine with just my regular presser foot on. If you have a free motion quilting foot, they're awesome for doing this, but I wanted to do it with something probably everybody has so that you can see it can be done, but the other one does make it easier. You can see better. So let's get started. I have found the center of my nose, put the presser foot down. Now, you definitely want to go back and forth, tie off that string, okay, and go down. All right, and we're going to go back up. We want 2 or 3 lines thick. All right, now this is like 1/4 inch from the bottom of the face, and if you look at the pattern, it goes about halfway up the nose, so like that. Then we're going to stop. We're going to get this thread out of the way, okay? We're going to trace that stitching right back. And there's where we started. And now I'm going to just do the same on this other side here. Come up halfway up the nose, so it's about even on the other side. And then follow those stitches back down. And I'm going to go over the mouth one more time, so that it's nice and dark. Then my back stitch, cut my thread, and you have the cute little smile. The cute little lamb face, and I kind of messed up his nose right here a little bit. So I'm going to take that. It was before I really got started. I'm going to cut that out. Make sure that that's back tacked right there so it can't come out, but there it is. So here's what his little face looks like. Now, if you're feeling adventurous, I'm just going to put a little curl in my black thread up here in this little bit of his hair. So I'm just going to start up here, and I'm just going to sew down and around and up and in and make just a little curl like that. It's definitely optional. I'm going to do it on my machine. I'll show you. If you wanted to hand embroider it, that would be fine also. again, if you have that open-toed free motion quilting foot, that makes that much easier, but I just wanted to show you, you could do it with that too. So now it looks like this, and other than his eyes, this little applique is finished. I wanted to show you on all of our other faces, we're gonna do them exactly the same way we did the little lamb. We'll do the big piece here with the backing of the pellon, the interfacing, so that we have a nice finished edge all the way around. The monkey ears, you can turn right side out. So if you wanted to do those so that you would stitch and then turn them right side out, or you can just do the zigzag like we did on the lamb's ears. You can see that his face is symmetrical. Okay, which means you can just trace it and put it on the Wonder Under straight away. You don't have to reverse it or anything like that. You'll do his nose and his mouth the same way. The little pig, same thing. His ears are bigger and would be easier to turn, but still you got that little point and everything. So if you just wanted to zigzag those ears, that would be great. His little nose, you would just use the Wonder Under to do that. Now mine, I'm doing it in fleece, the little fleece, and that you cannot iron. So be very careful with what you choose to use for texture, that it's ironable or not ironable. So just be careful. You don't want to melt it. The little kitty cat ears, pick how you want to do them. These little spots here, I'm just going to do with Wonder Under, and then like everything else, I'm just going to do the little applique stitch. Same with his nose. And last but not least, our panda bear. He's the same thing. So you do follow the same instructions all around. Now, I'm going to finish all these up, and I'll show you how to put the book together. I'm working on the panda bear, and I wanted to show you when I cut out the pattern, I cut it out leaving like a quarter inch seam allowance around the outside edge. I sewed it, and then I clipped the curve just like every half an inch or so, so that when I turn it right side out, it's gonna lay nice and flat. So that's panda ears. So anyway, you'll do that, and you'll use a chopstick or, you know, the end of your scissors if you're careful, something to poke it out so that it's nice and flat. And then I'm going to top stitch it down so that it stays nice and secure. All right, now for the face, these are the two eyes and the nose. They're very similar, so I put an N on the nose so that I know it's the nose. And you can just trace it right onto your Wonder Under paper. You don't even need to make another copy, because we're not going to reverse these. They just go straight on. So these are just some of the techniques that you can use on all the other faces too. And as individual ones come up with individual things, I'll show you. As you can see on the panda bear, I put him on a really dark background because he was white, but his ears kind of blended into the background. So to add another texture, this is just a piece of satin ribbon here. I'm going to stitch that down before I attach the panda to it so that his little ears will stand out. Plus it'll give it something nice and soft to feel. So I'm just going to do a stitch. This edge here doesn't really matter. This edge here is going to stop right in the center, and I'll show you what we'll do with that. I'm going to fold it under right at the edge, right in the very center, and you'll see when we finish what that looks like. Okay, as you can see, my little panda bear is done. He's been appliqued down. Everything looks really good. I wanted to attach a bow under his chin, like so. So I tied a bow in some grosgrain ribbon. I cut my edges, and then I used a lighter, like so, to just melt the edges so that they can't fray. Did that on both sides. Now I want to very securely attach this little bow. So I'm going to use my machine and sew down each side of this ribbon and across the top of the center piece. I'll show you what that looks like. So here's how I sewed down the bow. You can see I went around a couple times around the center, and I decided to go ahead and attach down these pieces here, but I left this part here so that it could be fun to play with for the baby to chew on and to play with. But it's very nice and secure and will not come untied. We're getting ready now to attach the eyes. All right, we're getting ready to do the eyes. I made small marks where I want the eyes to be. Then it comes with a little awl, and you poke a hole all the way through all the layers of the fabric where you want the eyes to be, like so. And then your snap pieces come, one of them has a spike in the center. That's the part that I want to show. I'm going to put that in, and then I'm going to put the back part of the snap on it here. All right. And it's the, I'm just using the one that's the innie part of the snap. You could use the outie too, but it just adds more bulk to your quilt, to your book, which we don't need. So anyway, this next part, there's so much fabric to get to the center. You have to kind of work it in for just a second. Okay. And you get it so that it seats. The eye part is going to go right in this piece here. You make sure it's in nice and good. And then the back, and then you just squeeze it literally as tight as you can. And it's going to smash out that center spike so that it's nice and flat. And these are practically impossible to get off. Believe me, I've made mistakes before and tried to get them off, and it's really difficult. So it's nice and baby safe. So I'll do the other eye and move on to the next step. Okay, so this is the inside front and inside back cover of our book, and now I'm ready to do the inside pages. One of the little things that's different about the lion is his mane. And so what I have is just a regular wooden ruler. Any kind of ruler would do. A chopstick, you could use a pencil, anything that you can put in the center of the ruler like this. And the reason for this is you'll pull this out and it makes the ribbon easier to get off. Take just the tiniest little piece of tape and tape the end of your ribbon at one side, and then just begin twisting it around, not tight, but twisting it around all the way down the ruler. All right, we're going to keep squishing it up here. So anyway, I'm going to twist this all the way down the full 12 inches of the ruler, and I'll see you at the bottom. Okay, I got down to about 10 inches like this. Okay, now the next thing I'm going to do is finish going around like this. I'm going to take a piece of scotch tape and I'm going to put it on top of my wrapping like this, just kind of down the center. Any kind of tape will work, but you want it to be able to come off pretty easy. You don't want something that's going to be super tough to get off. Okay. So I got all the way to the end. All right, then I'm going to undo this little piece here that was holding it on. All right, then I'm going to take out this little chopstick or pencil or whatever you decided to use. And what that does is it gives it more, it's not so tight on the ruler. Then I'm going to very gently pull it off the ruler, doing my best to keep it twisted up. And it looks like this when I get it off. You can see that it's all still twisted and it has that tape. The next step is I put it in my sewing machine and I'm gonna sew right along the edge of the first fold, as close to the edge as I can, but still catching all of those folds. Okay, and I didn't sew on the tape, I sewed next to the tape. Okay, then I should just be able to pull the tape off. All right, and pull all that tape off and you'll have the lion's mane. And I'll show you what to do with it next. So here's the little lion's head with the ears already just tacked in place. And now we're gonna take his mane and we're going to start at the bottom and we're just gonna pin it in place so that it goes all the way around the outside edge of the head. Okay, once it's all pinned in place, it should look something like that. Just like before, we're gonna measure over an inch away from the center back, place our little lion, and then we're going to sew him in place. I'm gonna use my applique stitch around, but make sure that the ears still have plenty of movement, and then of course the mane will have a lot of movement. So I'll see you at the end of that. So I finished by adding his nose with the Wonder Under, doing the line work, and adding the eyes, and now I'm ready to move on to the next one. Here we have the pig, and I did his ears the same way we did the first one, where I just overcast the ends. And this is a minky type of material, and you cannot iron it, it will just melt. So for the nose, I did the same thing as I did for all the other heads, and used the interfacing, and then just turned it. So now I'm gonna stitch it on in the right place and add the ears and eyes. And there's our little finished pig with a bow. When you're thinking about the placement for your animals in your book, if you're gonna put a bow down below, be sure to push it up just a little bit so that you still have a nice open area all the way around and that your animals are lined up. So let's work on the next page. Okay, now that I have all of my little faces done and I've added all the little embellishments that I would like on each of the little faces, we need to trim down the two pages that are going to go back to back that will be the center of the book to get them to be the exact same size, because we're going to end up sewing them back to back, and I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, I've trimmed these pages down so that they're the same size, and then I've taken some 1-inch ribbon and I've cut them 2.5 inches long, and I'm going to fold them into little tabs like this. If you've ever noticed, little children just love to play with tags on their toys and stuff to chew on them. So anyway, fold them in half, and then we're going to pin them around the book, around the page, around all the edges, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. Okay, I randomly placed the ribbons all the way around. You could measure and do it real evenly if that's what you wanted. This is your design, you make it up. I wanted to show you that I put the heads of the pins facing off the edge of the fabric, so when we put these together and sew, I can pull my pins out as I go along. So now that I have that side done, I'm going to make sure that I have the heads both facing the same way, right side up, and I'm going to put them one on top of the other like this, and then I will pin this together, marking, matching the center piece here and the ends here, and then I'm going to sew all the way around, but I'm going to leave about 3 inches open so that I can turn it right side out. Let me show you what that looks like. Okay, so here I am sewing it together. So I'm using a 1/4-inch seam. When I get to a pin, I pull it out and I run it clear off the end like that. Okay, I'm gonna clip my threads, then I'm gonna come back in, come back on the side, and I'm gonna do the exact same thing, sewing down the other side. I'm pulling out my pins as I go. Okay, I've sewn all the way around it and I left an opening. Because I had so many of these little tags right here, these little ribbons, I sewed halfway onto this one and halfway onto that one, back tacked on both sides so that when I'm turning this, I'm not going to pull my stitches too much. Now, each corner, I want you to take your scissors and cut off close to where you sewed but not into the stitches, because we want to have nice sharp corners when we turn our book page right side out. So do this on all four corners and then turn it right side out. Okay. Okay, now I have my page turned right side out, and you can see that the corners are still stuck in, so while I still have this opening here, I have a chopstick. You can use whatever you would like to gently push out those corners so that you have a nice sharp corner on all four corners. So go ahead and do that, and I'll meet you back here. Okay, so I have it all fixed. I turned in the remaining seam allowance here, tucked it in, and I pinned it close. Now I'm going to, I also, with a cool iron, just kind of press this a little bit, just around the edges. You don't want to melt your ribbon, so keep your iron nice and cool. And the one drawback with these little snaps, don't ever touch an iron to those because they will melt. So stay far away from your faces. I just wanted to give this a little press so that it laid a little bit flatter when I was going to top stitch around the edge. So I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, so here is what my pages look like this. And so now you can see why it was important to keep the faces both going the right direction. All right, so this is the center of our book. So for right now, I'm going to set this aside and we're going to work on the cover of our book. We're going to make the tie that's going to close our book, and I'm going to do this with a piece of Velcro. So to start with, this is a 2-inch by 9-inch strip of fabric, and we're just going to put it right sides together and run it through our machine using a 1/4-inch seam. So I'll sew all the way down. So here's my tube that I just sewed. I'm going to take a safety pin and I'm going to take just the very back of the tube, like so. Close my safety pin. Now I'm going to point it down inside the tube and then just wiggle my safety pin. It takes a second to get it started sometimes, but this will help you pull your tube right side out. So get it started and just keep pulling it along. And it'll just come right out the other end. Like that. So there's that. Turned right side out. Now I'm going to take this and I'm going to get it nice and flattened out. Okay, I'll press it and then I'll show you what we do next. Okay, so here is the inside front and back of the book, and this is the front cover of the book. Alright, so I'm going to take this tie and I'm going to put it on the back side of the book, in the center. You can measure if you want, but I'm just going to eyeball it there. And then we're going to do like we did before with our pins. We're going to put it outside like that. And then we're going to place the top on it like so. Okay. And then pin it in place. And we're going to sew around it and trim our corners just like we did before. So here is the cover of our book with our tie with it'll look like that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little thing where we can hang it on a stroller or anywhere that you want, so you can attach it to something so when the child drops it, it doesn't fall on the floor. So just take a 12-inch piece of fabric 2 inches wide and make another tube like we did before. Alright, so I just sewed down. I backstitched here, sewed across, backstitched a lot there, came up, did the same backstitch, backstitch here. And as you can see, I left about 1/2 inch for the spine of the book, and I sewed right down the tie, like so. So here's our book, all right. Has the little spine in the back. So now I need to measure over. I think I'm going to put the Velcro about right there. So here's our finished book with our Velcro tab here. I found instead of just zigzagging across the edge, I turned it up zigzagged and then put the Velcro over the top of the turnip, and it worked much better, went through my machine better. So anyway, there's that. And here is your finished little book. I just want to reiterate, if you have never used these little snaps before, practice so that you are 100% sure that you're getting them on correctly, so they're never going to come off. Let your design inner self go wild. If you have any little embellishments, this is just a little Notions daisy that I had, and I sewed every little piece down and sewed some ribbon with it. Just remember, kids love to have lots of textures, lots of colors, lots of things to feel. Anyway, use your design, go through your stash of fabrics. It just takes just the tiniest little bit for each one, so I'm sure you have lots of little scraps that you could use. And I hope you really enjoy this project, and thank you so much for stopping by and watching another Vintage to New video. Thanks. Bye.